it's a Romulan warbird.
In Cardassian space.
They've locked onto us with the tractor beam. Take the helm, I'm going to try to send out a distress signal.
I can't pull away. The tractor lock is too strong.
They're jamming our transmission.
Do you think you got through?
I don't know. I'm going to hail them and see what they want.
I think we're about to find out.
It's good of you to come. It spares me the trouble of having to send someone else to kill you.
Come in, come in. It's been a long time, Elam. So, you're a tailor now. Is this one of your creations?
A minor example of my work, yes.
I don't think I like the neckline.
Well, you always did have a keen sense of fashion, but you seem to have let it go, along with your once trim figure.
Constable Odo, I've always wanted to meet you.
I wish I could say the same.
Oh, come now. Haven't you ever been the least bit curious about me? About my relationship with Garrick? Or our work in the Obsidian Order?
I seldom waste time speculating about retired spy masters and their associates.
He's good. He hides his true feelings almost as well as you do, Elim. He'd have made a good operative in the old days.
I had the same thought myself. But then, those days are long gone. At least they are for me. You, on the other hand, seem to have left your retirement far behind, unless you're simply on a pleasure cruise with your pointed-eared friends.
Cunning, isn't he? He makes a racial slur within earshot of two Romulans, putting me in the position of either defending them, thus giving away my allegiance to them, or letting the comment pass, in which case he's managed to plant a seed of discord between us.
Frankly, I don't find any of this interesting. You both go to such lengths to hide the true meaning of your words, you end up saying nothing.
I think you'll find when I have something to say, you won't have any trouble understanding it. To answer your question, Garrick, no, I'm not on a pleasure cruise. This ship is part of a fleet of Romulan and Cardassian vessels, a fleet that will very soon be traveling through the wormhole into the Gamma Quadrant.
I take it you're not on a mission of peaceful exploration.
Not exactly.
You're going to attack the Dominion, aren't you? You're going to stage a first strike against them before they can come into the Alpha Quadrant.
A clear and precise analysis. Commander Sisko must find you a valuable advisor.
A daring plan. I didn't think there was anyone in the Central Command bold enough to take on the Dominion.
Who said anything about the Central Command? This is a joint operation between the Obsidian Order and the Tal Shiar. We've been building a fleet of ships in the Orias system for months now.
If you attack the Dominion, they'll certainly strike back. You'll be taking Romulus and Cardassia into war. A war you may not win.
I don't think they'll be striking back. Our intention is to wipe out the Dominion in one single blow, by eliminating the Founders. Without them, the Dominion will collapse. You seem disturbed by this, changeling.
Why?
After all, didn't you turn your back on your people?
You seem to know a great deal about me and my people.
We know everything you know, including the location of their homeworld.
Starfleet has shared their intelligence on the Dominion with the Romulans.
And the Romulans have shared it with me.
You'll forgive me if I reduce the scope of this conversation to something a little more personal. But why was it necessary to kill me and the rest of our former colleagues in order to embark on this excursion into the Gamma Quadrant?
Because, Garrick, I don't plan on going back into retirement when this is over. I plan on going back to my old job and my old life.
You were afraid we knew things, things that could be used against you, and so you decided to have us eliminated.
Like I used to say, always burn your bridges behind you. You never know who might be trying to follow.